go to aws.amazon.com, right? So in this session, like, I'll show you how to, you know, how to create two instances in Amazon EC2, right? Amazon EC2. Okay. Is everyone on this page? Now you have some, okay, let me come from the beginning. Instead of console, you start with aws.amazon.com, right? So now what you do is, there will be something called free tier when you start in the beginning. I think it is, hold on 1 second. You should see something called AWS free tier. Okay, or else do this thing. Google for Amazon free tier, right? So you'll land up on this, go to the first link and you land up on this page, AWS free tier. Is everyone on this page?
Not yet.
So if you use this, like, you can, you know, with load runner, you can install controller and load generator machines on two different machines, right? As well as you can set up JMeter master and slave, right, on two different machines. So that is the purpose of doing this, guys. Okay. And this is, you know, like, once you are on this page, click on create a free account. And enter your details, right? And if you observe here, like, AWS accounts include 12 months of free tier access, right? Including use of Amazon EC2, Amazon S3, Amazon DynamoDB. Okay. So, like, you will get 1 year of free access.
Okay.
Provide your details here, user email ID, password, and, you know, like, give some AWS account name and click on continue. So I already have an account, okay, or else I will do one thing. I'll create with some other, some other email ID. All right. So I gave an email ID, password, and account name and click continue. Sorry. So
here personal account,
Akisha. You can give personal. Okay. So are these fields mandatory? It's not marked as mandatory, right? Anyways, so let's give.
Kishore, phone number edaina parleyadu kada?
I can give, no, better give your original number. I mean, valid number. Give valid number.
Kishore, India aina US aina parleyadu kada? Finish ayyaka istane. If it is asking for any OTP.
Yeah. So here you have to provide your, credit card or debit card details. Okay.
Is it mandatory, Kishore?
This is mandatory. So basically, like, this is required mandatory because if your usage is above, like, you know, free tier limits,
yes,
right? So you have something called AWS free tier limits, right? Go through that link once. So okay, if your usage is more than that, like, you know, then they will, it will be chargeable. But for the first 12 months, it is free, provided, you know, like, you use only, like, Yeah, here it is. 750 hours free. Amazon EC2 free tier. For the first 750 hours per month, it is free. Okay.
Okay.
And also, you know, like once you log in, right? So you'll have some, you know, like different machine configurations. So machine with one processor and 1 GB RAM, machine with one processor and 2 GB RAM, two processors and 2 GB RAM, two processors, 4 GB RAM, two processors with 8 GB RAM and so on. So you'll have both free and, you know, machines which are free and as well as machines which are chargeable, right? So based on that, like, you know, you will be charged. So, you know, but so this credit card or debit card details is mandatory.
Okay.
So if someone is spending, what is that?
It won't detect automatically, not right?
No, unless until
after 1 year, after completing
unless until you cross that 750 hours per month, right? It won't charge. For 750 hours per month, it is free. It won't charge anything. But you have to, you know, when you are configuring the machines, you have to make sure that you are using free tier or, you know, like, one second, let me log into, you know, my account, which I already have. Right. is anyone completing this sign up process?
Company name, what to do?
Personal. Where is company name? You gave personal, right?
Yeah.
I think you selected professional. That's why it is asking company name. So you said
it is by default
personal.
Yes? Sure, I will sign up later because I don't know the credit card details.
Okay. Is anyone doing that? Just give some if you know, like you. It won't charge automatically, guys. Like it won't charge, you know, without ever, it will send proper mails to you. If your usage is exceeding that 750 hours, right, per month, it will send a mail. And, you know, like, but only thing is you have to configure only like free tier. If you configure free tier machines, it won't charge anything, even though it is above 750 hours.
Sir, after 750 hours, it will give any information, sir. We have to pay money.
750 hours, so I know.
750 hours
and 31 days. 24 is 31 days, right?
Yeah, 31.25.
Yeah. So if you are using only free tier ones, like, you know, that is completely free because it is coming to 31 days, right?
Yes, sir.
So malli next month ki malli start avutundi.
12 months.
Right, you are getting 31 days, right? So, you know, like, unless until you use high configuration machines, it won't charge anything. Okay. You can't use all configurations. You can't use high configurations in the free tier.
We can use 12 months without any charges, Kishan, right?
Yes, if you are using free tier, some configurations will be eligible for a free tier. Right, it will show it there. Once you log in, when you are configuring the machines, it will show you like which machines are free tier eligible or which configurations are not eligible for that free tier. Okay, so you need not worry about that.
Process chesa na?
Yes. Enter your credit card or debit card number and, you know, verify and add.
Okay, 2 rupees charge chestunnaru OTP vachindi.
Right. It will charge 2 rupees just for verification.
Okay.
Just for that is for card verification process. And it will be refunded. That two rupees also will be refunded, it seems, once your card has been validated. Okay, let me also enter. Okay. So I am logging into my existing account. So once you log in, you will land up on this, you know, AWS management console page, right? So go to, you know, like launch a virtual machine, right? Click on this link, launch a virtual machine, right? And observe here, like, you know, AMI stands for Amazon Machine Image, right? You have different AMIs here, right? Amazon Machine Images, right? My AMIs and all these, right? Community AMIs and so on, right? So you have to select, like, you have to select the OS and which operating system you want, and, you know, which operating system, as well as what processor and all. I think you have option to select, you know, I think operating system, and so here you can see these are all free tier eligible: Amazon Linux, Red Hat, right, SUSE Linux, and these are all free tier eligible for free tier, right? So select this one, right? So select this by Microsoft Windows Server 2019 base. AMI stands for Amazon Machine Image, right? And select this one, click on this one, 64-bit processor and all, right? So you can see other servers as well, other, you know, AMIs as well, different AMIs as well. And not all are, you know, free tier eligible. You have to select, you know, something which is free tier eligible, okay? You have an option to select the operating system as well as a version of the OS, right? So you have here like Server 2019 OS, and you have like, you will be having like 2016, Server 2016, right? Windows 10, I think we don't have, I couldn't find it. Okay, you can search over here. So let me search for first Server 2019. Right, this is Server 2019, right? Let me search if this, yeah. So the search is working fine, right? So give Windows 10, try Windows 10, right? So Windows 10, they are not found. 17 results in AWS Marketplace. Okay, let's try this. You're not seeing Windows 10, right? So it is showing Windows 2016 and so on, right? So, you know, let's go for the default one. Go to Quick Start, right? And select this Microsoft Windows Server 2019 base. Once you select that, it shows like, you know, what all are eligible for free tier, right? So here you can see. You see here, right? T2.micro, this is free tier eligible, correct?
Yeah.
So micro instances are eligible for AWS free usage tier for the first 12 months following your AWS sign up data. Means if you register today, like from today, you will get 750 hours of micro instances each month, right? When your free usage expires, or if your usage exceeds the free tier restrictions, you pay standard pay as you go service rates, right? So you select only this one, right? See, this is free tier eligible, right? You select this one only. But this will be very slow because it is only 1 GB of RAM and single processor. It will be very slow. What you can do is, like, you can select this, you know, 2 gigs of RAM or 4 gigs of RAM, right? But, you know, you have to make sure that once you are done with your work, you have to make sure that you stop that instance. Got it?
Yeah.
Because if you exceed that 750 hours, like it will be chargeable, right? So if you want to learn more about free usage tier eligibility and restrictions, click here. So 750 hours per month of, you know, T2 micro, T3 micro, instance dependent on region. So T2 micro, T3 micro are free, right? Let's go back to the previous page. It's not showing an option to go back. Okay. T2 micro and T3 micro is also eligible. That's what it said, right?
Yeah.
But T3 micro is also 1 GB only.
Two processes and 1 GB.
Right. Okay, anyways, so, you know, you can, so you have to make sure that, you know, like you stop the instance after once your usage is done, right? So I'll just show you the steps where, you know, just I'll go with this T2 micro and to show you the steps, that's it, right? So go to select this T2 micro where, you know, like number of CPUs is only one and memory allocated is only one, and you know, like next click on this next button, configure instance details. So once you go here, so you know, like if you want, suppose four instances or three instances, you can select here. I want two instances to set up, you know, at least to set up like JMeter master slave or load generator, load runner controller and load generator, right? So I want at least two instances, means two machines. Got it? Guys?
Yes, sir.
Right? You give the number of instances over here and, you know, like you select, you can select the subnet. You see here, right? AP South 1, 1A, 1B, 1C. Right? So you can select any subnet over here. I'm selecting AP South 1A. Right? This is optional. If you don't give any, you know, if you don't select anything, it will assign some default one in any availability zone. As we are in South now, AP South, like it will give some in one of the available thing in the subnet. Okay. Is it clear?
Yeah.
I selected AP South 1A. Okay. If you don't select also, you know, it will select default subnet. Okay. So next, you need not select anything over here. So shutdown behavior, let's see what is this. Okay, stop. Enable Hibernate as an additional stop behavior.
What purpose do we use this?
If you want to try JMeter master slave setup, or if you want to try like a load runner controller and load generator thing, right?
Okay.
So you have only one laptop, right? So yeah. What you can do is you can use this Amazon free tier, but but you have to select some 4 gigs of RAM and like that, actually. Okay. But you should be careful with the usage, because you have to enter the credit card or debit card details. You know, like if you start the instance, if you start the machine and leave it, you will be charged for that. Okay, that's why I'm selecting. I don't use this email ID. That's why I'm using this, you know, the completely free tier one. Okay.
Okay.
Even though if I forget it, I will not be charged because this is free tier eligible. Is it clear?
Yeah.
So when you are selecting instance, like you can select, you know, 4 gigs of RAM. Better select two processor, select this one, T2 medium, 2 CPU and 4 gigs of RAM. Okay. But make sure that you will stop the instance once your usage is done. Clear?
Yes, Kishore.
right? So next, next, you know, click on this next add storage button, right? I selected two instances. Now what you do is click on this next add storage, and you know, you see by default it will allocate 30 GB of hard disk, right? The storage. Previous one is RAM, right? 1 GB and all this, that is 1 gig, 2 gig, that is, see, GB is pronounced as gigs, right? So you have to pronounce as gigs, right? So previous one is like regarding the RAM, right? Now this is regarding hard disk or storage. So by default, 30 gigs of RAM, 30 gigs of memory will be allocated. Means you are getting a 30 GB SSD. Clear?
Yeah.
So a magnetic means this is normal, you know, hard disk. Got it? What is magnetic and what is SSD? Okay. Magnetic means your, you know, normal hard disk, like the old one. SSD is the, like, you have solid state drive. SSD yes. stands for solid state drive.
Yes.
Okay. By default, it is showing SSD. Leave it. Okay. And, you know, if you 30 gigs of memory is more than enough. 30 gigs of, you know, hard disk space or storage space is more than enough, right? Free tier eligible customers can get up to 30 GB of EBS general purpose SSD or magnetic storage, right? So you can select, we can go ahead with the default one. 30 gigs is more than enough. If you want to install controller, right? So you may need to increase this. LoadRunner controller, if you want to install LoadRunner controller, you may need to increase this. You have to check the, you know, system requirements. Let me show you that. LoadRunner 2020 system requirements. So let me show you the, let's verify like how much of, you know, see, this is LoadRunner Professional and LoadRunner Enterprise system requirements document, right? So if you look into this, if you want to install controller, right? If you want to do a full installation of LoadRunner Professional, right? You require at least 2-core CPU. Minimum is 2-core CPU, but 8-core CPU is recommended. And RAM that you require is 8 gigs of RAM required, right? Recommended is 16 gigs, but 8 gigs of RAM would be sufficient. And see here, available hard disk space is 50 gigs, right? So if you want to install controller, LoadRunner controller, you have to increase this hard disk space to at least 50. Yeah.
Yeah.
Right? But I want to do JMeter. I don't want that much now. So you understood the requirement, right? See, if you want to install LoadRunner complete installation, you need at least 50 gigs of hard disk space. Clear? And the RAM required is 8 GB, right? And CPU is 8-core CPU is required, right? So you select whatever you want in the, when you are configuring, you select whatever configuration you want, right? So I will go with the default one, right? Because, you know, like I want to use only this free tier. I have like, this is first just for, you know, demonstration purpose to you. Okay. Next, once you know, click on next, like you can give a name to these machines, right? Add tags means like you can give names to the machines. Okay. I will give the name as JMeter. Free tier. This is free tier machine, right? Or I will mention as T2 micro. That is the one I selected, right? T2 means tier 2, right? T stands for tier. This is what I selected, right? T2 micro, right? So I'm giving that name just to, you know, like, see, once you launch all the instances, then you will understand what is the, you know, what is the purpose of giving a name or tag over here, right? So here we have to, you know, like you can go with the new default security group, right? And you can click on review and launch, You can give some description over here if you want. So once you are done with this, like you can click on this review and launch, right? So it is showing the whatever we have selected. T2 Micro is an instance type that I selected, and it is free tier eligible, right? And you know, like it has one CPU and 1 gigs of memory, and you know, like let me click on this launch. Now, so what is it saying? Select an existing key pair or create a new key pair, right? So key pair means a key pair consists of public key that AWS stores and private key file that you store. So basically this is used as a password when you connect. See, once you configure the machines, you have to connect to those machines, right? This will be used as a password, right? So, you know, select, create a new key pair and give the name. So this machine is like, 1 second. So I gave some name to this, right? JMeter, I'll select that as T2 Micro, okay? And download key pair. Click on the download key pair. It's not downloading. Hey, are you able to download here? Is anyone on this page? Yes.
No, sir.
Sai Manoj, how about you? So actually it will be downloaded, but I'm not sure why, you know, like, oh, hold on. So private key file is required to obtain the password used to log into your instance to securely SSH. You have the description over here, right? What is the, you know, like, what is this key pair, right? So basically for Windows AMI means, or for Windows AMI means?
Amazon Mesh Image.
I explained just now in the previous screens, one of the previous screens, Amazon machine image. So if you are using Windows machines, the private key file is required to obtain the password used to log into your instance, right? I'll show you how to use that password. I'll show you that, but somehow, you know, it is not, it downloaded now, right? So you can see here a PEM file got downloaded. A file got downloaded with extension PEM, okay? Yes, is it clear? Whatever name I gave here, like, you know, it got downloaded with that name. Now click on this launch instance. Now your instances are now launching, right? Let it, so now, you know, once you are on this page, go to view instances. Now you see here, right? These two are the instances that I configured just now. Right? These two, it will show the instances like this, guys, right? You have instances, nothing but you have two machines now, two free machines that you got from AWS, right? So, and observe here, the status check is like empty here. It should complete the status check, right? So key prefer, it will take some time, 3 to 4 minutes. Now the status check is initializing, right? And here you can see the, you know, region in which they are allocated, right? Yeah, I selected a 1A, right? But it's allocated in 1B.
No, Kishar, you selected default.
I selected default, okay. But let me show you like how to use these machines, and then we'll we'll go back to that the previous session that we are in. Okay, so keep refreshing the. I mean, like it will take 3 to 4 minutes actually to initialize. You should see that, you know, two of two checks ani ila green low. You should see that, then you are ready to use those machines. So we are hearing this cloud and all, right? Nowadays, like AWS cloud or GCP, right? So this is your, this is that cloud, whatever, you know, the buzz is about.
Okay.
Okay, I'll be back in a minute. It will take some time. Right? Now you can see like after 3 to 4 minutes, you see like these two of two checks are completed and you know, you see that in green color, right? The status check will be in green, right? Now these machines are ready to use. So now let me show you how to launch the instance, how to, you know, how to use that instance. So we have to connect to that machine, right? We have configured two machines in AWS now, right? So now we have to connect to those machines, right?
Yes.
Right. So let me show you how to do that. I selected this T2 micro, right? So or else I will go ahead with the like previous one, which I have configured. This is medium one. And if you see here, this is with 4 gigs of RAM, JMeter slave. I gave the name as JMeter slave 4 gigs, right? I'll select that one. And you know, like the process is the same. Okay, wait, hold on, wait. So I need to download the setup, the password, right? So I will take with the, I'll take the machine that I configured just now, right? So this is the machine that I configured just now. These are the two machines that I configured just now, right? So select one of them and, you know, click on this launch instances. Oh. Something wrong. Hold on, let me re-log in. Something went wrong. And by the way, you can see the billing details over here. My billing dashboard. If you click on billing dashboard, you'll see like, you know, if you are charged something for your usage, right? So yesterday I used these machines, like I told you, right? I used like, I set up two machines for, you know, with one with 2 gigs of RAM and the other one with 4 gigs of RAM. So I was for one day, I forgot yesterday to stop this and I was charged like 72 rupees for that. Okay. And remember I used, you know, like I did not use free tier ones. I used machines with 2 gigs of RAM and one machine with 4 gigs of RAM, right? So that's why I'm charged this much. And also like I forgot to stop them, okay? So it will show, if you go to the dashboard, billing and cost management dashboard, it will show you like how much we have to pay. So this is for one day, that is fine, right? So it's 72 rupees. For complete, almost like it was, they were running for like 10 to 15 hours, I think. Morning, I started them and I remembered that before going to bed. Then I stopped them, okay? That's fine. So let me go to the...
launch instances lo drop down menu untada
akka no So you have to select the instance and you have to click on connect. Launch instance is like if you want to select the instance, right? So you, now I selected the instance that I have launched. Let me, you know, that's fine. Okay, leave it. So let me show you like how to connect to that machine. So this is the machine that I have configured just now, right? So click on select that machine and click on connect, right? And go to, once you are on the screen, go to RDP client and download this, you know, remote desktop file. So if you want to connect to any remote machine in your network, like you use this MSTSC, right? Or this one, remote desktop connection, right?
Yes.
Right? So in the same way, like to connect to these instances, you have to click on this download remote desktop file. Right? And you see now like one RDP file got downloaded with the name that I have given. Now you understood, right? This is the tag or name that I have given, right? You understood what is the purpose of giving name?
Yes.
Right. So once you download this RDP, then what you do is you have to get a password. So basically, if you have a machine in your network, right? If you already have a remote machine in your network, so you enter the IP address of that machine and click on connect, and you have to enter the username and password, correct? Right.
Yeah.
Did you use this RDP anytime?
Yes. Yes.
Right. So what you have to do, you have to enter the IP address of that machine and you click on this connect and you enter username and password. Now for these machines, this is the username, right? For this AWS instance. Now you have to get the password. So for that, click on this get password, right? And previously where you downloaded one key pair, right?
Yeah.
And that is a private key, right? That is a private key. Or, don't bother about what is public key and private key for now. So, but you remember, like, we downloaded one PEM file, right? PEM file, right? Mm-hmm. Click on browse and select that PEM file. This is the one we downloaded at 8:42, right? And open that and, click on this decrypt password. So this is the private key, right? So click on this decrypt password. And you will get this, password like this. Copy that password now and save it somewhere. So what is this machine name that I have given, like JMeter T2 Micro, right? And this is the password for that, right? Okay, now what you do is, once you get the password, right, go back to that EC2, right? It will show all the instances running over here, right? You see here, right? Instances running, it is showing 4 instances I have configured, means I have configured 4 machines, right? And all are running, it is showing the status. Now, select the machine and click on connect. We are already done. Now what you do is go to launch my remote desktop client by using MSTSC, right? MSTSC stands for Microsoft Terminal Services Client. Can you note it down if you want? Microsoft Terminal Services Client, right? Or else you can type remote here. In the search bar, you can type remote desktop connection and select this one, right? Both launch the same window, right? So now what you have to do is you have to give the we downloaded one RDP file also, right?
Yeah.
JMeter T2 Micro RDP, double click on that, right? So to connect to that machine, we double click on that RDP file and click on this connector. You see the machine name over here, right? EC2 13 126 218 something, AP South 1 compute.amazonaws.com, right? So click on that connect, right? And we saved the password, right? Enter that password over here. So this is the password for this machine. If you click this, don't ask me again for connections to this computer. It won't repeat this every time, right? So check this checkbox and click on yes. Now you are connected to that machine, what we have configured. We have to do the setup everything. I have already set up yesterday on other 2 instances. I will use that. I am using this just to show you like how to connect to those machines and all. Okay. So now your instance is getting ready. Okay. It is getting configured. Let's wait.
Internet access
Yes. you will have everything. You will have internet access, but only thing is like you need to, I'll show that, like you need to do some settings on the browser side to download files and all. Your instance is ready now. Your AMI or Amazon machine image is ready now. Okay. So and once you get this, you know, once you get this window, click yes. You recommend, we recommend allowing this on your home and work networks, but not public ones. So what it is saying is, do you want to allow your PC to be discoverable by other PCs and devices on this network? Say yes, that is fine. Now your, you know, this is your remote machine is ready, and you can see the, you know, public IP address, private IP address over here, right? I think I have explained you what is public IP, what is private IP also in one of the sessions. How many of you remember? And it is showing the total memory, like we allocated 1 GB machine, right? We selected 1 GB, right? That's why it is showing total memory is 1024 MB, right? And you can go to, you can verify here as well, right? So this is one CPU. We selected single CPU, right? You can see, see over here, number of sockets is one, our virtual process is one, and memory is one GB only, because we selected that one, because that is completely free, okay? Now, you know, like if you want to install JMeter and all these, like you have to, first what you have to do is like, you will be having internet on this machine, right? And as someone asked, you know, like you can, you will be having internet on this machine, but thing is you need to do some browser side settings, okay? So let me show you that. By default, you will not be able to download any file, okay, on this. Right, so you have internet, right? So you will see like this, you know, like you will not, your internet will not work properly like this, right? So what you have to do is, first you need to, you know, like do some settings over here. First, to enable this menu, I clicked on Alt F and, you know, go to view and select menu bar, so that these options will be visible every time, right? Now what you do is go to tools, internet options, security, uncheck this enable protected mode, right? And we have to, you know, you will by default file download option also will be disabled. For example, let me show you that. I'll go to Apache JMeter site and try to download JMeter. Right, this is your Apache JMeter site, right? I'll try to download JMeter. Okay, so I'm clicking on this binaries. So it is saying that you are attempt to download a file from a site that is not part of your trusted sites. Okay, so what you do is click on this add, so that this site will be added to the trusted sites. But still, you know, you will not be able to download by default. You can see nothing is getting downloaded, right? Hey, wait, let me save. Let me try to save. Yeah, now it is getting downloaded. Once you add to the trusted site, then it is it got downloaded, right? Now, you know, like you can see JMeter download has completed. So meanwhile, can we run that JMeter directly? What is the prerequisite for running JMeter?
Okay. Yeah.
What is that?
Install Java.
Right. We need to install Java on the machine, right? If you want to run JMeter, right? So oh, let me download. this site requests JavaScript to be enabled. You get this warning, you know. These are just one, you need to do one or two like prerequisites for this, right? It is saying protected mode is turned off for the internet zone. That is fine. I click on don't show this message again. So see here, you know, like once you go to this Java site, like it requests JavaScript to be enabled. It shows that it requests JavaScript to be enabled. So you need to enable that JavaScript. Okay, go to this security and, you know, like go to custom level and so file download, by default, it will be disabled. Select enable. And we need to select a scripting as well, okay? So like, I think like previously we used to have a tab called JavaScript, a section. Like, I'm not sure if I'm checking at the right place, but let me try to do that.
Enable scripting and
enter. Enable scripting, right. So script access, script access ActiveX controls marked safe for scripting. You can enable this because only those marked safe for scripting only we are enabling. Okay. And enable scripting is not there here, right, Sagar? We didn't see that anywhere.
ActiveX scripting.
Here it is. So in scripting, you have like active scripting. I'm not sure if this is JavaScript or not. Okay, let me enable this. So active scripting, I am enabling. And scripting of Java applets. Okay, let's try one more time after selecting these settings. Right, now you got the page, right? Now click on this agree and start download. Right, we are on Java download page. So our JMeter is extracted and it is ready. Right, so go to bin and let's place a shortcut on the desktop. First, you know, enable the extensions, file name extensions by checking, you know, file name extensions. Now you can, you know, see like jmeter.bat. I'm placing a shortcut on the desktop. Okay. So you have a shortcut on the desktop now. So let's complete that Java download also. So Java download is completed and, you know, click on run to set up Java on this machine. As this machine has only one processor and 1 gig of RAM, it will be slow. Otherwise, it would be very fast. Like if you selected like four CPU, four core CPU and 8 gigs of RAM, or, you know, some high configuration like that, it will be faster. You can see CPU is hitting 100%, right? Because it is just one core CPU. Java installation is done. Click on close. Right now you can before launching, you know, before installing Java, like you, if you try JMeter, like it won't work, right? Obviously it won't work, right? I should have shown that. Okay, but that's fine. Right now you can launch JMeter on this machine. All right, now you can see, like, you know, you can do the follow the same process for the other machine. We configured one more instance, right?
Yeah.
So you configured one more instance, right? So what you can do is you can follow the same process on this machine, and you can use this one as one machine as master and one machine as slave. All right?
Okay.
All right, so let me stop recording and we'll, you know, now that you understood that, like, how to start the instance and how to use that, right? You know, once you are done with your work, what you have to do is, you can see the status over here as running, right? So you select that instance once you are done with your work, right? And you use this stop instance or terminate instance, okay? If you use stop instance, you can run it again. Whenever you want, you can run the same instance again. But if you use terminate instance, all your, you know, that machine will be gone, right? And all that Java installation and JMeter, that complete, the machine will be gone if you use terminate instance. Clear?
Yes.
Right? If you want to, you know, like, use it, if you want to use that in future, like, what you do is just click on stop instance. Then it is stopping now. So do that for the other machine as well. Okay. Let it complete. Let me inspect this, and, you know, the second machine, I'm stopping the second instance. You got it, right? You got the difference between stop instance and terminate instance, right?
Yes.
Remember to stop the instance, right? Or else if you don't want to use it anytime, you just terminate the instance, you know, or that machine will be, like, if you want to use it again, you have to do this, all these steps. From launch instance. Is it clear?
Excuse me.
Now you can see those, it is not showing the two instances, right? Because, of course, there is a filter here. If I click, remove that, you know, you can see that two instances are stopped, right? These are the two machines that I configured just now. These two are stopped, right? And you will not be charged for this, you know, T2 micro. If you select T2 micro, you will not be charged anything for 1 year. Okay. Now, you know, let me, I'll stop it here, stop the recording here. So this is how we can, you know, like, configure AWS instances and connect to them. And use those two instances. All right. Yes. So next time, if you want to use the same instance, you select that instance and go to instance state and start, use this start instance. Okay. And you see a confirmation message, successfully started that machine. Right. And, you know, you have to wait till this 2x2 checks are completed. The status check should be completed. So it will take like 1 or 2 minutes, right? Now it has initialized just now. So it will take not 1-2 minutes, but it will take 3 to 4 minutes to start that instance and do the status check. Okay, I'll stop it here. Anyways, we are done, right? So I'll stop the instance. So if you want to restart the instance, like, you can use this, you know, reboot instance. All right. If you want to restart the machine, you use this reboot instance.
What is the table at the
right? This is another one good feature. Like if you go to monitoring tab, you can see CPU utilization and all, right? Resource utilization, basically you can monitor that machine. So now let me show you, like, you know, if you want to terminate these machines or if you want to delete those instances, select those instances that you want to terminate and go to instance state and click on this terminate instance. So it will ask for a confirmation. So click on terminate and now you can see it is shutting down board, right? And you know, like this will be gone from this console. So you can see here successfully stopped and successfully terminated. You see a confirmation messages at the top, right? So now they are terminated. If we refresh the screen, these two instances will be gone. They are still terminating. Hold on, just wait for a minute. They're terminated already. So maybe it takes some time, but you know, these two machines will not be visible to you after some time. Okay. And we will be using these two machines tomorrow, right? To complete the master slave setup. So basically I want to give you, like, you know, idea about what is this, you know, what is this cloud and how does, you know, organizations use these different clouds like AWS and GCP and so on. This is how any like cloud provider will have a console like this, web login like this, and they will be using those machines by, you know, configuring and using those machines like this. Okay. So I will upload this to my YouTube channel. So, you know, stopping the recording. So this is for like YouTube channel viewers. So like, share, subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.